blowing bubbles, an art that some people have turned into, believe it or not, a profession. The Exploratorium this weekend, and the star attractions are two noted, get this, bubbleologists.
I'm glad you said that.
We sent Emil Guillermo to see how they do it.
Bubbles, soap and water, pure and simple. But to others, they're gems of scientific explanation.
The scientists, they're important because they show some basic laws of the universe are at work on bubbles in a way that is nearly unaffected by gravity and some of the other forces that mold everything else. Bubbles are liquid spheres. Liquid can move in an infinite variety of forms and insist on going to the minimal form.
Tom Noddy's been blowing bubbles for 11 years. With a pack of generic cigarettes and some dime store bubble solution, Noddy's taken his bubbles from the street straight to the Tonight Show. He does a bubble called Galactica. And the Mount St. Helens bubble.
Now you remember from the news reports, Mount St. Helens started with an earthquake, right? And the whole mountain was trembling. Then there was an eruption.
It's a unique approach to bubbles, but certainly not the only way. Ask 84-year-old Eiffel Plasterer.
I'll prove that it would be spherical. If it had a chance, I'll take this side out, that side out, and this side out, and this side out.
Plasterer, a former high school physics teacher from Indiana, is the dean of known bubbleologists. Bubbleologists?
Oh, I guess so. That word's kind of big for me. See, but it's I think it worked all right.
Yep. Bubble master,
yeah.
Plasterer has been on the road since the 30s, illustrating physics through bubbles, like the law that says for every action, there's a reaction. But mostly he's learned of life from the lowly bubble.
I think I'm trying to do just what Tom's doing. I think that's what any good Sunday school teacher's trying to do. Do something to inspire kids. I don't think they need lecturing. I think they need inspiration. There are people who say life's just a bubble. No, that's not. They say life is like a bubble. Well, that's a lot better. But to say that life is like the blowing of bubbles, that hits it, because that's what our hopes and dreams are the bubbles of life. I think that they teach us very a lot. I think they're wonderful. That, gentlemen, is my hardest trick.
Life is like the blowing of bubbles. What do you think?
I haven't heard that one before. I don't think I've heard it. But, you know, I think if I had a physics professor like Eiffel Plasterer, I probably would have paid attention.
You know, I think that sounds great. And if you want to see that, you can go to the Exploratorium this weekend to see if you should check out a career in bubbleology.
Great career.